That was an easy win! place will have what I'm looking for.
You said something like that before. I didn't ask since I thought it might be something personal. But what is it that you're looking for, Aisha?
Well, it's a flower. A certain flower that only blooms once every 100 years in a plain. Oh, but if that plain has become a wasteland, then maybe the flower withered and died as well.
Oh, hold on! I'm not sure if it's once in 100 years, but... I've heard a story about a flower that's always been a bud. And it's not too far from here. Would you like to go see it?
Yes, I'd love to go!
Okay, then I'm gonna go back home and let them know where we're going. After that, I'll meet up with you near the flower. So the bud is located...
Okay, I have a good idea of where it is. I don't think I'll get lost.
Okay, then I'll see you later.
A big bud.
When my grandpa was a kid, his grandpa told him that even back then it was always a huge bud.
Then maybe it's been like this for about 100 years.
Isn't it marvelous? It doesn't look like it's withered at all.
It looks just like the flower in the book. I wonder how I can get it to bloom.
I asked my grandpa, and he said this flower lives a really, really long time. And like you said, it only blooms once every 100 years. So for 100 years, this plant stores up nutrients, preparing for the flower to bloom. And when the time is right, its flower blooms for a few days. But it's been a long time since its last bloom. My grandpa hasn't even seen it bloom.
I see. Maybe that's because this area has become a wasteland. In that case, if I give it some nutrients, maybe this flower will bloom.
Oh, Aisha, that's gotta be it. I feel like that'll do the trick. But how do you prepare 100 years worth of nutrients?
I think I can do it by synthesizing something with plenty of nutrients.
Really? You know, I'm starting to get really excited now too! You just might be the only person who can make this flower bloom!
All right, I'm gonna do this! Huh? That's... I wonder if something's wrong. She's crouching down by the road. Nanaka, is something wrong? Can you stand?
Ah!
Oh, sorry! I didn't mean to scare you like that.
No, no, I'm okay.
Is something wrong with the cow?
Yeah, we were walking fine until just now. And then she suddenly lost all her energy. Poro, what's wrong? Does your tummy hurt or something? Whoa, she's in so much pain. She sounds like a piggy. Aisha, what should I do?
Maybe it's an acute sickness. Is it okay if I take a look? Let's see. Huh? The area around her tummy is hard, and it looks like her intestines aren't moving. This is...
Is it some kind of bad illness? But that sounds serious.
No, no. This is, well, it seems like it's stuck.
It?
Well, constipation.
Oh, I see. My goodness, I told you a million times not to eat any weird grass. Bad girl!
Oh, I know of a good medicine.
Medicine?
Yep. I don't have it on me since I have to make it differently for animals. But if the symptom's as light as this, medicinal herbs might do the job. Give me one second. I think I saw it growing around here. Keep you waiting. I'm sure these medicinal herbs will do the trick. They're a little bitter, so I wonder if she'll eat them.
Don't worry, she's not picky about her food. She's so greedy, she's a handful.
Oh, she ate it! I'm glad!
Okay, good girl! I'm happy for you. Now say thank you to Aisha. Whoa! Already? Goodness, that's really embarrassing.
Maybe her intestines started moving after eating the herbs, and now she went to go do her business.
My, her business. Anyways, thank you, Aisha. You really helped me out.
No, no. I'm glad I was able to help.
Aisha, you were like a veterinarian. You look so cool.
A veterinarian? That's a great job. I'm glad she's okay now. But overeating isn't good for you.
It seems like you've helped Nanaka. Thank you.
Yeah! Mr. Brother! How long have you been here?
Eurus, your bad habits are coming out again. You're hiding your presence too much.
I didn't mean to scare you.
No, no. I'm sorry I got scared.
Sorry, I just unconsciously hide my presence. In any case, this is a nice opportunity to thank you. Because of Nanaka's job, she can't help but estrange herself from people. I'd appreciate it if you could keep being friends with my younger sister from now on as well.
Of course! I'm happy that I made more friends!
If you see her again somewhere, please say hello to her. Bye.
Whoa! I've never seen my brother talk to someone for that long before!
Huh? That was long? He only says the minimum amount that's necessary to people who aren't related to us.
I see. Could it be that your brother doesn't like other people?
I don't think so. I think he's just a quiet guy. He's often by himself in the forest or up in the mountains, so he doesn't interact with people that often. I guess the same's true for me, too.
What kind of job does he have? Since you mentioned forests and mountains, is he like a lumberjack?
Simply put, he's a huntsman. He's out running after beasts most of the time.
I've heard that animal horns can be used as ingredients for medicine. So, you two might already have some kind of connection, Aisha.
Yeah. Maybe your brother's helped me in some way before. I wish I could have given him a more proper greeting.
He wanders off as soon as he's done with his business. But if you could be friends with my brother, it'd make me happy too.
You're right. I'll greet him properly the next time I see him.
Yes, please.
I knew I'd find you if I waited here.
Mr. Key! Thank you so much for the other day. I've been studying hard, using that book as a reference.
There's no need to thank me. Putting it to proper use is entirely up to you. Besides, I'm not here to talk about that. I was thinking it's about time. Let's go somewhere we can talk. This is going to take a while. You have a workshop in this town as well, correct?
Yes, but it's a bit messy.
I don't mind. An alchemy cauldron. Your method is quite old-fashioned, though it does have a certain charm.
It's the same medicine cauldron
cauldron I've always used. Stirring cauldrons helps me relax.
I can't agree or sympathize with that, but it's your personal preference, so I would have to assume it's true. However, such a simple bookshelf. It seems you have unique books on medicine, but your collection is still meager. Does your knowledge come from an oral tradition?
Yes. Half of it came from books, and the other half was taught to me by my grandfather himself.
So the skill was fully passed down from one generation to another?
No. My grandfather passed away before he was able to teach me everything. The amount of the ingredients or the ratio of the mixtures are pretty much guesses. But I'm pretty confident that I kinda know what makes it work or fail.
I see. Guesses and kindas.
You're laughing at me.
No, I beg your pardon. I apologize if I make you feel bad, but I didn't mean to look down on you. However, this workshop is severely lacking. Let me give you this.
Wow! I can really have this? Wait.
I'm not surprised that you recognize it. It's from the village where all those people disappeared.
That's right! You took it away from me.
I still won't tell you what this vessel is. However, don't move it from here, or it won't be useful. Now, sorry to keep you waiting, but let's move on to the main subject.
Yes?
I have a job for you. I want you to use your alchemy to make me an item.
Use my alchemy?
That's right. It can be anything. The medicine you specialize in making, or a rare metal. However, you are restricted to creating something under the assumption that I will be using it.
You will? That's a bit... Would you really be satisfied with an item that I make?
The point of the request is to see if that's possible or not.
Huh? What do you mean?
Before I tell you that, let me tell you an old story. No one knows about it in this area, but where I'm from, a few decades ago, alchemy was rediscovered due to a certain incident. Many people put their hearts and souls into mastering their skills. To us, alchemy was possibility itself. My colleagues and I were elated with the excellence of alchemy. However, one day I came to realize that no single person truly understood alchemy. That everyone was a sham alchemist who had only scratched the surface of the art.
Sham alchemists.
Satisfied with showing off their insubstantial knowledge, some never bothered to pursue the truth. Others refused to even try to understand. Even if you simply imitate the form, you can use the skill to a certain extent. However, the things they created were nothing but shams. To me, that was unforgivable. Alchemy books, equipment, facilities. I destroyed everything. Because of that, I have become a man on the run. Though, I don't regret anything.
I understand your story, and what you're trying to say.
Yes. Depending on the matter and nature of what you create, I may take alchemy away from you. Alchemy should only be handled by those worthy of it. It's sacrilege for someone without ability to pursue it.
I can understand that synthesizing with only partial knowledge of what you're doing is dangerous. But to save my sister, to save Neil, I need alchemy. You taught me that. So, why?
This and that are different problems. Hey now. Why are you assuming that you'll fail from the beginning? You just need to convince me that you're worthy. I won't set a specific deadline. When you finish something that you think is right for this, bring it to me. I'll prepare a generous reward as well. That's all I came to say.
What should I do? This is really major. I might be forced to stop doing alchemy. I just have to make something super and make sure Mr. Keith approves of me. I wonder if I can do that.
finally obtained it. My very own castle. For me. By me.
Whoa, he's such a tall man.
From now on, I can bake whatever I want to my heart's content inside this castle.
Castle? Bake? Excuse me. What are you going to be doing here?
Here? This is going to be a bakery.
Oh, a bakery? How exciting! Freshly baked bread is so tasty!
That's right. Bread is delicious. It brings harmony to various dishes and gives us the vitality for life. That is the power of bread. Flour and rye, butter and egg. This weaving harmony of fascinating ingredients is a melody of the angels.
I see. I can tell that you probably really love bread.
Oops, sorry. I got too passionate. I can't help myself when it comes to bread. After all my training, I'm finally ready to open my own shop. This is a deeply emotional moment for me. Now, I can bake my ideal bread, which has long been my dream.
Your ideal bread? Does that mean you're aiming to make delicious bread?
It's a little different. My ideal is to get many people to eat my bread. And through my bread, I want to make people smile. I hope I can accomplish that with this bakery.
Wow, that's a great goal! Please do your best.
Thank you. It'll still be some time until the grand opening, but I would greatly appreciate your patronage.
Yes, I'll be looking forward to it. A bakery! I can't wait to eat freshly baked bread. Is this... is this? Is this a